All right, special delivery from Hobbylink Japan. Just arrived a few minutes ago. And as you can see, it's a nice big box. And you'll know what this is from the video title, obviously, but this is the first time I'll be seeing it. So let's have a look at what we've got. Upside down, of course. Oh, that's a big box. I wasn't expecting it to be this big. Hi, Sam here at Model Chili, and here is Bandai's Space Battleship Yamato 2199 at a 1 to 500 scale, which comes out at about 26 inches long, or 666 millimeters, according to the write-up. And to be honest, I've never actually seen the TV show that this is based on, or any other media relating to it. It's just one of those kits that I've seen around on the internet and thought that actually looks pretty cool. So I did a bit of research around on the various kits and found a reasonably priced one on Hobbylink Japan. And I just went for it, and so here it is. And it's based on the real battleship Yamato, obviously. And it comes with various fighters. And I've also actually ordered an expansion set that includes some winglets and a fighter bay, so that should be coming soon. I thought I'd just get a closer look at this beautiful box art on the cover there. I hope to replicate some of this weathering on the kit, the chipping and the bit of a rust and oil wash in the various grey shades on the hull. Should be quite fun. And so let's have a look inside the box. And so there's the contents of the box. Lots of plastic, instruction book, and some decals. So let's get a closer look. Okay, so just a quick look through the instruction book. So it's all in Japanese, as to be expected. But if past Bandai kits are any indication, then it should be fairly straightforward. So go through various sub-assemblies there, and a nice double-page spread. The various parts of the ship and all the scenes from the TV show. Pretty simple colour guide, really. And more sub-assemblies. Building up the bridge parts. And this is where the extra fighter bay goes from the expansion set. And painting guide on the back. So the ship itself should be pretty simple. I'll just do various shades of grey and then red. And then painting up all the fighters should be quite fun. I think you get 8 in total. And then we've got decal sheet. So just lots of warning stripes and a nameplate for the stand. So looking at some of the parts, we've got the part of the upper deck here. And a base of the bridge superstructure. Some of these parts have come loose in the box. It shouldn't be too much of a problem. And hull plates for the side. And from what I've gathered, this is a observation windows area. I have picked up little bits of information during my research. Even though I'm not that familiar with the ship, there are certain parts that I've picked up. And some of the red parts. the massive bulbous bough at the front. And it would be tempting to not paint these, since this is such a really nice red. Would be kind of nice just to not paint it and then put it together. But there's quite a lot of, not quite sure what it's called exactly, but just sort of casting different lines and textures with how the plastic's cooled, I guess. So those would still show up even if you do various gloss or flat coats. So I'm just going to have to prime the whole thing up and then paint it from scratch. But I was kind of planning to do that anyway. Now these kind of look like internal bulkheads, which is kind of cool. I guess it would need to if you're having it internal detail like the fighter bay. There's a bit of internal detail here as well. And some pretty big parts for the keel, the underside of the ship. I'm not sure if naval terms are appropriate for a spaceship, but who knows. Some really nice moldings. It's a typical Bandai crispness. Again, more parts that have come loose. It's a good job these gates from the runners are quite small, so these can break off easily without damaging the part. Now this is one of two identical sprues, but we've got all the fighters on here, various different types, and some of the guns. And some more of the external hull. And just a single sprue for the clear parts. So windows for the bridge and for the engine, I assume. And other bits and pieces. And a front part for the wave motion gun. Some nice ribbed detailing in there. And then there's various sprues for all the turrets and the guns, the big turrets and the small turrets. And here's the main engine exhaust. And this piece actually came detached from the sprue in the box, but it doesn't look like it's been damaged, so that's good. And more red parts. This is for the section underneath the ship. And a nice hefty stand base and stand itself. And then finally just a few more sprues of just detail for the superstructure. Various fins and railings, more turret parts, more guns, and more turrets. And I do believe that's that. Phew, that's a lot of plastic. So let's get building. Okay, so what I've started doing is putting together some of the larger sub-assemblies to get away with as much building as I can before I need to paint. And so there's some of the Ford hull being put together there. Now I'm just about to put the top deck plating on. And then once I've built up as much as I can, I'll prime it and paint it, and then once it's all painted, all the separate pieces are painted, then I'll start sticking it together. So like these separate grey and the red areas will be painted separately. So for the red hull parts, I'm just using Vallejo's fire red, and I think it's slightly transparent because what's happening is the more layers I put on, the darker it seems to get. So I'm able to achieve this sort of pre-shaded effect with just using one colour. So I can get some nice panel shading going on there just by applying more coats of paint once it's dried. And now I'm just finishing up some of the small parts. So now with the pre-shading done, am I ready to put on the main hull colour, which is Vallejo USAF medium grey, which is kind of a bluish grey. Thank you. And that's all the construction complete. And I just need to pan around just to get it all on the camera. And I haven't actually stuck down the command center in the middle. It's just sort of sitting there. So I can take that off and then flip the ship around and work on the underside a bit easier when I start doing the weathering and the decals. And the next step is to give it a light gloss coat with Tamiya Clear TS13. And then I'll paint up the stand and start working on the fighters. So now with the decals done, I'm just going to start giving it a wash using Vallejo Grey. And I'm just going to coat the entire model. Let it sink into all the recessed areas. And then clean it up once it's dry. Now with the wash mostly dry, we're just using a bit of airbrush thinner on the end of a smooth rag, and then just start wiping away the areas of wash that I don't want. Hopefully leaving it inside all the gaps. Okay, so now with the main wash done, I'm just going to start doing a few of these oil stained streaks, just using Tamiya's Weathering Master set. And this just rubs on the staining colour. And the trick is just to make sure you stay straight. And then it can easily just be corrected with a bit of water on the end of a cotton bud. And I'm using this metallic blue just to do the ends of the turrets, just to signify that it's not your typical gun, but more of a space laser. Now I'm just going to do some very light chipping using silver, just to replicate the box art, which shows quite a bit of chipped paint. And with the weathering complete, I've just given it a couple of coats of Tamiya's flat clear, just to seal everything in. Now I can finally lock down the top section. Just get a little bit closer here. And hopefully this just pushes down like that. Sorted. And there it is, all complete. So with the fighters on the stand, I'm happy to wrap this one up. It's been quite a lengthy build, but I've tried to cut the video down as short as possible, so I have skipped a few bits here and there, so hopefully it's not been too confusing. But as always, if you've got any questions on any of the techniques or the paints, then please leave a comment. And yeah, so it was really fun to build up. Being a Bandai kit, it was the quality was really good. This wasn't quite as perfectly engineered as some of the new Star Wars kits that Bandai have released. There was quite a few gaps and not perfectly fitting parts, but overall I was really happy with it. And it was all snapped together, so I didn't really glue a lot of it. But yeah, so let me know what you think in the comments. Leave a like or a dislike. Always interested to hear your feedback. Especially since this is a subject that previously I've known nothing about. As I've mentioned, I've never watched the TV show or anything, so I've come into it pretty much blind, really, and just painted it based on the instructions and the box art and a few references on the internet. And I've tried to strike a balance between the cartoon version and a gritty, realistic, battle-hardened version, so I didn't want to weather it up too much. So hopefully I've struck a nice balance between the chipping and the streaking and the overall paint job. And I'll just get a close look at the fighters there. They were just hand-painted and then given a light grey wash. It does actually come with two of each, but I think one of each on the stand is enough. And the extension set did arrive, so that's all ready to be built up. And that just contains the fighter bay, a load of fighters, and the little wings, which I'll be building up in a separate video, so keep an eye out for that. And I'll just do a quick close-up flyby. I'll put up some close-up photos on my Facebook page, so I'll put a link to that in the description so you can go see those there. I'm also on Tumblr, Twitter, and Instagram, so I'll put links to those as well. Just a way to follow my build updates, progress on various models, and other random bits and pieces. And if I can reach to the back. And here's just a look at the starboard side. Pretty much the same, really. There wasn't a lot of detailed painting, just the main grey and the red. And then the weathering, and a few decals here and there. So overall, it was quite a simple job, in theory anyway. Wasn't quite so simple building it up, because there's quite a lot of sub-assemblies that I had to do and paint before attaching everything, so it was a little bit challenging, but again, it was really fun to build up and to paint and to weather. And I still think it's a really cool concept. And definitely worth getting, even if you haven't seen the show. It's just something really different and interesting for the collection. At least I think, anyway. But again, let me know what you think. And I hope you've enjoyed watching the build. And until next time, take care.